your hands like you're reaching for the stars. When we stay supreme, y'all stay pause.
I want a clean fight. Are you ready? Get it on!
Welcome back to another exciting episode of Supreme Bars. I am your host, Roberto De Jesus. Halloween is over! Ah. I know, my favorite holiday. But now we celebrate another holiday. Actually, a month-long observance and acknowledgement of Native American culture. And we want to honor our first settlers with a full episode of education, enlightenment, entertainment. We normally do a Thanksgiving episode, but I can no longer honor genocide. Hate to sound negative over a rap tournament, but I'm just keeping it real. This land was their land, not ours. Onto the show. Before we dive deeper into tribal tribulations, I'd like to introduce our illustrious three judges. Same as last month, and they are...
Yo, what up? It's your boy Sidenine, champion MC, doing it right now for the November edition Supreme Bars. So you already know I gotta represent Scorpios all day. I wanna see some get LMCs, some dope ass beats, and you already know, man, I wanna see y'all give you 100%. Let's do this. And I also look like a Sith Lord. I shall judge you this look.
Yo, what's up? This is Lex Rush, six-time Supreme Bar MC champion. Happy Native American Heritage Month. Glad to be here with you all. And psyched to share a new project, new group with Dale Novella and 28 Rakes. It's called LXDC. We got a new track, This Love, out right now. Check us out.
Peace. What's going on, y'all? It's the one and only D9 to the Master, 9-1 to the 4, Money Earner to the Mount Vernon. We in the building. You already know. One-third of the Soundation Mafia. The filthiest of all roles. Silco Slice. You see the do-rag. It's not a game. Here from judging one more time, Supreme Bars. Let's get it. Let's go.
Gattels, you are missed, but D-Nasty, thank you for taking over for now. If you haven't heard yet, D-Nasty is officially part of Legendary Cyphers, a freestyle movement that can be witnessed over at Union Square every Friday between 8 and 12. Definitely check them out when you're in the NYC area. All right, producers will go first, and we have a few previous competitors from Jersey and Philly. Please let them know who you are and where you're from.
What's up, Supreme Bars? Stanley Ipkiss, coming from Jersey, going from win number 11. See how it goes down.
What's good? It's your boy DJ Les, aka the Magnificent DJ Les, back up in effect. Straight from Brooklyn, New York, currently living in Philly right now. I'm gonna give a big shout out to Supreme Bars for putting me on. Got a beat tape coming out real soon, Soulful Sounds Volume 3. Been on hold, but I'm gonna bring it out, drop some soulful tracks, know what I mean?
Hi, my name is David Milkus, aka Milk. I'm a musician born and raised in New York City. I'm also a beat maker, producer, and music publisher. Right now, I'm working on my very own debut, Flawless Filth, and I'm also producing for an artist, rapper, friend of mine, Rio, and his untitled studio debut album.
Peace, what's going on, world? It's your boy, Mac Amazing from New Jersey. Yo, check my project out that's out right now. It's called Starting From Scratch on all streaming platforms, and I got something coming out real soon called Music Is Amazing. I'm here to bless y'all with some fire. Let's go.
Perfect. Welcome back, everyone. And as always, your first round beat will not be judged, so the audience can get an idea of your producing skills. You know what? We all live in unceded indigenous territory without knowing which tribes ruled the land before us. Education. Let's reveal who owned these major cities before we colonize them with new names, starting with LA. But don't let the knowledge stop there. For a deeper dive, please check out nativeland.ca, spelled out right here, and explore an interactive look at indigenous lands before the colonizers came into play. Don't forget to zoom in for details. You can really learn a lot from this map. Okay, producers, it's time for the judgment. Who will be taking home that November trophy? Let's hear your second round beat and find out.
Crazy.
This is a hit track.
Came through and murdered that. Oh my god.
He's like he's dope as hell when it comes to his flips, how he does things.
So this gets an 8.5.
10 out of 10.
Strong 9. Fire.
And that's the Ace Disposable Arts vibe.
He ain't doing nothing with that. I'm gonna have to holler.
Give it an 8.5. It had a real crazy Wu-Tang feel. I really liked it.
8.5. I like that.
It does have a lot of potential though, so 7.5.
Mac Amazing
storytelling, like,
not sure if it like really comes together for me.
I don't know what's in the beat machines, but yo, all of these people are going crazy. Let's go.
Tough to catch, which is why I gotta give it a 6.5.
We got a 9 as well.
It was nice. He definitely could use some work. You can give that a 7.9.
Posse Cutters type vibe.
Laid back, rustic, kind of like hippie vibe.
RZA, Doom, probably Q-Tip on.
Definitely another solid 7.
6.5.
Solid 8.
Okay, we have hype beats and we have laid back, lo-fi tracks. But who will make the cut in the final round? Let's see.
Heads across the board. My man came for the gold and came for everyone's head. That's all I know. He came for everybody's head.
Very cheeky. It's keys heavy.
That's a 10. Yeah, it's a 10 right there, yo. 10s across the board.
Still very good. 8.5.
Give that man a shining 9.
This is a quite nostalgic November.
It was pretty cool, you know what I mean? It was cool.
I'd make a song to that.
I want to like this more and it has a lot of potential.
We'll give that a 7.7.
So 7.5.
We'll get out of 8.5.
Minimalism can be fine, but it just doesn't come together for me.
That was solid. That definitely went hard.
I mean, he is bold for going so minimal, but 6.5.
Get out of calm 8.
Once again, you know what I mean? I like to see more of him and I'm gonna give that a solid 7.
Rock with this one. He did some nice layering with the different horn parts.
I feel like it was very bare bones and I would like to hear more drums on it.
Fire. He definitely did that.
This gets an 8.
That was a solid 8.
We got a strong 8.5.
And that was the final round for producers this month. It's time to reveal the winner. Michelle, if you will. I don't know what to say. I mean, Ipkiss, you might have to retire, man. He's unbeatable. I think he has as many trophies as the Green Bay Packers. Producers, please don't stop competing. You can only get better from here. DJ Les is trailing closely behind. If any of you out there think you have what it takes, hit us up. That's www.supreme-bars.com and message us for details. And please, follow us on all platforms and get to know our competitors a bit more. Before we get to the MC portion of the show, I wanted to shed a little light on the most popular holiday in November. Not to ruin your turkey day or anything, but have you ever sat and thought about what Thanksgiving meant to those who were affected by the holiday? I want to give the floor to Native activist and playwright Larissa Fasthorse.
I love the idea of Thanksgiving. I love the idea of a day of gratitude and spending time with your family, and I actually love the weird food. What I don't like is the underlying tragedy and genocide that we ignore on that day. To set up children from the age of preschool to believe that it's right and okay to just take everything is actually truly horrible. It's teaching appropriation from the very beginning. I thought I knew a lot as an Indigenous person about Thanksgiving, and the reality is, like, nothing we've been told is true in just one fact. So many political reasons that Thanksgiving, the mythology of Thanksgiving, kept morphing over the centuries to fulfill political agendas, right? Just like today. I think the hardest thing for Americans today, and the reason that Native Americans and Native American history and issues get left out so often, is because it hasn't ended. We are all still complicit in standing on stolen land. The first step is just to know whose land you're on. Figure out who the indigenous people are in your land and then start to get to know about them. Start to figure out how you can make reparations. And maybe it's just education, maybe it's getting your kids' teachers to stop doing these terrible, racist, horrible Thanksgiving pageants they do. You know, I don't know what it is, but everybody has a capacity to give back something. And you need to start with knowing who you need to give it back to. And if everyone just did that on Thanksgiving, we would be eons ahead in this country than we've ever been in the history since, you know, Columbus showed up.
Thank you, Larissa. And for more info on the true history of Thanksgiving, we have a link below by dosomething.org that includes things you can do to help honor and acknowledge Native culture. Without further ado, let's get back to the tournament. MCs, once again, sorry to keep you waiting. Let everyone know who you are and where you're from.
Hey, what's going on? This is Case, crew, MBW, HFP, coming from Kingston County, Brooklyn. I'm going to destroy your beats, take your instrumentals, and steal your microphones. Peace.
Hey, it's Ladarrell, coming from Memphis, Tennessee. I just dropped a new single called Under Control.
Yo, yo, you already know it's your boy Demented, FNM Music Group, Demented.com. Spire's coming this month, just a few more days, and you already know, man, back into it, trying to get this W.
What's going on, guys? My name is Rio Asul. I've been working on an album. I have merch dropping sometime soon. Instagram or Twitter, @Rio_flows. I'm on YouTube, Spotify, all that stuff. And, you know, give me some feedback wherever and whenever you want.
Normally, I do these things as Steve Almighty, but I'd be remiss if I didn't acknowledge other identities that have been built in parallel spaces elsewhere in the multiverse. So, yeah, I'm going to be Scuba tonight. I'm still from Yonkers. I still got kids. I still teach, right? But, yeah, we're going to go by Scuba tonight.
Ladarrell, welcome back after obliterating everyone in that Star Wars episode not too long ago. But let's get right to it. Freestyle artists, if you can please give us an 8-bar intro so we can get a better feel of your style.
I love the way Rasan breaks it down to the sound. Now you know, in case if you forgot my name, what's whole case 929. I just redesigned the whole way you hear it. Now I spit it straight from my mind. This is how it goes. It's just intertwined like a fine wine. This is how it goes. It's an old vine. I'm an old grape. This is how I just take the way I just rake.
Okay. I said I drop hella rhymes. Motherfuckers better recognize it's that Ladarrell guy for the second time. Yes, understand I'm the best with the freeze. I never be stressed, I leave them impressed. They got some terrible flows. I disappeared last time, they thinking where did he go? Oh, yeah, but we know Ladarrell's a pro. And I guess after this, we'll just start with the show.
You know, when it comes to introductions and bugging, Demented ain't really prepared for nothing, but I'm gonna come up with something on the damn spot. This is what I'm talking about. I will not give up or quit. I'm coming for the win. I hope I'm well equipped. I've been in the gym, practicing the bars, coming off the head. The beat dropped, but man, I heard what I said.
Hey yo, baby, I said I loved you from the start. Even when my car wasn't starting, you was the one that I wasn't parting with. My only love till death duly departed. Understand, I don't really want to start shit, but I like to start shit. I like the way you get mad, and really just in my soul I get glad. Looking at your bright smile every single time I think about all of the hours we would spend for a while now.
Scuba out here getting 3 stacks, but I ain't talking Andre. I'm the type of person disrespectful in your house. I don't give a f*** about what your mom say. I mean, watch the napalm come around, that's just the way the bomb spray. You know I'm out here with a long name, psych. Scuba probably out here capping. Couple bars, give it back, know that I'll be rapping, let's go.
No doubt. You can tell already this is going to be an amazing competition. On to the judgment. You know I'm a huge fan of TV shows and films, so why not incorporate that with our overall theme this month? This round will include scenes of Native American actors and films you may recognize. MCs, rap about whatever you see. You know the drill. Best of luck.
Now that guy's looking kind of spiteful. Hit him with a motherfucking sniper rifle. Oh shit. You know it's a horsey that they're riding on, cause they're finna start the war scene.
Yo, I know the time and the tale. Here it is, how the natives, the First Nations, we don't bail.
You know what it is, don't got the bail. Hope one of my homies gon' get me out of jail. And over here, we gon' run out of there. You know what it is, in my damn underwear.
Now these rappers, now they be frail fake. They wish that they could be like this and do a jailbreak. Wow, matter of fact, they don't fall out. This guy right here, he got to pull the
Native
wall out.
Native Americans acting in Hollywood, trying to do the best they could. This is how it goes when Case gets on the beat.
Damn, what he talking about? You know he's trying to go to the promised land like a walkabout. He come around, I mean, the world is looking west now. Scuba out here probably been the best dressed now. But damn, I mean, I gotta give it up to fine linens. It's funny, indigenous out here with the fine women.
So now, it's all about the sacrifice, trying to get what's coming. in the afterlife right now. We all want the blessings. You know what it is, man. I'm trying to teach you a lesson. And
I'm a bloodhound moving through the cityscape. Mighty Kukulu Khan. Understand that I'm blue like my man's here back in the day. 99, you could see and maybe even hear about it or read about it up in the paper. The way I hold the hearts of the people smoking like a vapor.
I had to put this dude in his place, cause he thought he was bad, putting a gun in her face. But dang, matter of fact, they start to attack. They had to pull that freaking tomahawk out of his back. And now the kid's training, we're insane. And
what they want from that shit, I mean the haka. Always got him going, you know the claws out like Baraka. I'm feeling like I'm in New Zealand, damn. Feeling like the demon always coming about, running down the track like I was really beaming.
Always gonna stay master wild. This is called the revenant. Pulling up like a revenant. My benevolence is evident. Understand that I'm rolling through the forest and I might hit you with something like seven men, huh?
I guess that there's some more cowboys, but they ain't ready for us. We always been some wild boys.
Giving a make them run upstream. That's how it is when you a reservation dog from the reservation. That's how I speak. Constantly get this like it's a musical genius.
I'm a man out here looking hard on a three-wheeler. Scuba out here almost like Gee Wheeler. That's right, that's a Captain Planet reference. If you don't know, I mean the heart out here look demented.
3D, now she's a queen of the Shibas. I mean queen of the heaters. Holding that for real like Fritos. Chipping, chomping, bison at her neck now. You can see it's confident, hard.
All right, folks, if you want to know where these scenes came from, just check below in the description and enjoy. Judges, how did the MCs do this round?
He knows this stuff when it comes to natives and indigenous tribes, and he was tearing that up crazy.
Could tell he has like a good amount of knowledge.
That was real, real solid.
Yo, I'm gonna give Cash Gear in that first round. That's a solid 7.
So 7.5.
I give him an 8.
Ladero, yeah.
Punch after punch, image after image. Like, I'm glad to see him back. He's sharp.
He definitely has some ill references in his verse as well. He goes off.
Solid rhymes, tomahawk into the backseat.
I give him 8.
I'm gonna give 7.8.
So 8.5.
Demented really, really, really stepped it up this time.
And he like really sells his bars this time around.
And Demented did his thing. He definitely flowed through that.
All about the sacrifice, trying to get what's coming in the afterlife. Really good job. 8.5.
7.7.
Man, I'm gonna give him an 8.3. He came through and killed that
Son Rio flexing with the intergalactical background.
My man Rio was really on his
Definitely a complex MC, very thoughtful.
He knew what everything was, man. I'm gonna give him an 8.7.
9.2. That's like my birth year. Let's get it.
9.5 overall, like killer round. He did great.
The Mighty Scuba, as he now calls himself.
That's his new nickname. Tell him that word. Scuba Steve.
I mean, Steve's always on point.
His references is crazy, too.
And he got the haka dance line.
I'll give that an 8.4 for the scuba man.
He did great. That's a 9.5.
9.5. Enough said. I'm fine.
Not too bad. Good job returning champ Steve Scuba, on to the next round. We mentioned Thanksgiving, and as the Supreme Bar's tradition, we ask that artists give thanks to what they have and the people in their lives. Simple as that. No word generator, no visuals. Just let us know what you're thankful for within 8 bars. Starting with Case.
Back in 99, I left a life of crime. I'm so happy that I decided to change my mind. The way I thought about life, it was a different mind. A young man's mind. Growing up with a single mom. Living in bad neighborhoods. I'm so grateful that I made it through so many poverty-stricken places and schools.
Yeah. I'll show you how grateful the Ladero feel. I'll tell you a story and it is hella real. And I'll tell you that this story is hella ill. Here's how I got my first f***ing record deal. My school has a label called Blue Time. It makes me feel fancy like Grey Poupon. And last week we just did our first show. And it was kinda short, I only did 2 songs. It wasn't too long.
Said I'm thankful for my wife and I'm thankful for my kids. Thankful that I'm alive, so I'm thankful that I live. Thankful that I get a chance to get this shit right. You know what it is, we ain't always bad at night. What we need to be, this is what I'm talking about proceedingly, trying to be the best me and me. You know what it is, this reflection is demented. I hope that you get it and comprehend it.
I'm thankful for all of the food on my plate. I'm thankful for a roof on my head. Thankful for the pieces of bread that stay on my plate and everything that's scraped all around it. My mother, my foundation, you know I found it right inside my heart. You can see it glittering gold. I'm so thankful for everything that was sold and priceless unto me, passed on to me, and I'ma use it for the rest of history unto me. Word.
Chances I only earn what I need. I'm thankful for watching my son while he's learning to read. I mean, the damn shit is so explicit. Sometimes I feel like I was really born gifted. I'm thankful the way that my father's able to build a relationship with my son. I mean, that's on some patience. Sometimes I have trouble. Scuba out here probably had to earn a rack and a double. It's no problem. You know I gotta do it for the kids. Type of shit I gotta do right before I live.
From record deals to family to no frets, no regrets. I personally think you should all get a 10, but thank God I'm not judging. Judges.
He had thoughtful and impactful bars about trying to do the right thing in life.
Very heartfelt, very relatable.
Thankful for his mom, you know, who doesn't love that?
I like that. Yeah.
Yo, Caskey in the third round, he did another solid 7.
So that's an 8.
8.2.
So really cool story about him, like, getting a record deal through his school.
He definitely doing a lot better than a lot of people I know.
Bird, I appreciate what Darryl was talking about, the record deal and all that.
I wish they had something like that at my school.
So I'll give it a 7.5.
He didn't ask.
7.7.
Yeah, he listened. Demented.
Yo, Demented's round was probably the best round of the whole Thankful series.
Thankful for his wife, his family, his kids.
Classic bars, strong start.
He went straight for the juggler with it.
The flow sounded great, so 8.
8.5.
I'm gonna give that a 9.7.
Rio Azul, listen.
Did awesome. Like, the pieces of bread that stay on my plate line.
He was holding shit down.
Fire, 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 fire.
The foundation, talking about his mom.
He flows and how he delivers.
A solid 9 right there.
Again, nearly perfect. 9.5.
Get out of 9.5.
Steve Almighty.
Scuba Steve is another one, man.
Great with the thankfulness, you know what I mean?
I like that he was talking some multi-generational stuff.
And from the 914, so you already know.
I dug this one a lot, too. He gets a 9.
Shout out to the kids. 8.5.
9.3.
And there we have it. Supreme Bars Native Nation has come to a close. Who will be the champion MC for November 2021? Let's find out. New champion and mega freestyle artist Rio Azul rose through the ranks and finally got that golden microphone trophy. Definitely well deserved and just 1 point away from Scuba Steve Almighty. Wow. MCs out there, if you've been watching and you're ready to enter 2022 with a win, hit me up. www.supreme-bars.com. And once again, follow us on all major platforms to get to know who we are and our competitors as well. I'm Roberto De Jesus, and before I leave, I just want to provide a few more websites of information so you can further educate yourself and hopefully contribute to organizations aimed at the advancement of a humane society for generations to come. Stay blessed, everyone. Peace.